Welcome back to STS. In today's video, we're going to use integration to find the area of a triangle. We're going to do that by creating two lines. So let's begin by drawing our coordinate plane, and let's focus here on the first quadrant. Let's say that we have a line, and that line has a slope of b over h. So for this particular line, the equation is going to be y is equal to b over hx, because that's the slope. And since we're going through the origin, the y-intercept is 0, so we don't need to write the 0. So here we have this line defined in slope-intercept form. And let's say we have a second line, and that second line has the equation x equals h, which tells us that that's just a vertical line that intersects the x-axis at a value of h. And with that, we know that this height here is also b. So again, if we're trying to find the slope, we'd have to go up b units and over h units. So now that all that's defined, we can now create an integration problem. So we draw our integral. Our x values are going from 0 to h. So our low is 0, our high is h. And I didn't say this, but we're trying to find the area located inside this triangle here. That's what we're doing with these two lines. All right, so our equation here is b over h x dx, and we're going to integrate. First, the b over h is a constant. It's the slope, so it's going to come out to the front. And again, we're integrating from 0 to h, so we have to integrate x dx. All right, when we integrate x, that becomes x squared over 2, and that has to be evaluated from 0 to h. Keep our constant out front, b over h. And here we're going to substitute the x value with this h. So here we have h squared over 2. And if we try to input the low, which is 0, everything here becomes 0, so it's no need to write that. At this point, we need to multiply these two quantities together. Well, I see that I can cancel because I have two h's up here and one h down here. That h cancels out completely, and I'm left with h to the first power in my numerator. So here I have b times h over 2, which is the same thing as 1 half times the base times the height, which, if you remember, is the equation for the area of a triangle. Now let's redo this again, but now let's put in some values so that we can solve this numerically. All right, let's say that again we have this line, and let's say this line has an equation of 2x. And let's say we have a vertical line that has an equation of x is equal to 10. So when I drop this down, I know this length here is 10. And now I have the equation for my integral, which here is 2x. So I'm going to take the integral from 0 to 10 of 2x dx. I'm going to keep my constant of 2. And when I integrate x squared, that becomes x squared over 2, and I'm evaluating that from 10 to 0. I see these 2's cancel. So in fact, when I substitute in the 10, I've got 10 squared, which is 100, minus, well, actually just the 10 squared, which gives me 100. Well, and I can do the minus. And then minus, when I do the lower boundary, 0 squared, which is just 0. So I see here that my answer is 100. Square units. And again, if I were to do this without calculus and integration, if this length here is 10, that length there is 20, I know the formula is area is equal to 1/2 the base times the height. Well, the base I'm going to say is 10, the height is 20. So if I take 1/2 of 200, I still come out with 100, which is what I also found here. So we see that both methods work. All right, that sums it up for this video by Spell Tutorial Services. Please friend us on that Facebook and also subscribe to that YouTube channel. And as always, thank you for watching.